Welcome in, Dean Richards, Sunday morning. We always bring you VA listers. Normally, the recorded interviews that we do in Los Angeles or California. It is rare that we get an A-lister in our studio 9 a.m. on a Sunday morning. And a real treat to have one of the stars of Disney's Wizards of Waverly Place. That's just a part of what Selena Gomez is. She is a recording star. She has starred in several movies and about to step up front with her own motion picture called Monte Carlo that opens next week. What a treat to have Selena Gomez here. Thank you for coming in.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
Nice to have you in with us this morning. When did you get into Chicago?
I got in last night around 7 or 8.
It's a nice night last night.
It was very beautiful. My friend and I walked around and shopped a little.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Are you able to walk around? Do you put a baseball cap on or something?
No, absolutely. I mean, it's completely fine. We actually had a nice night and weren't bothered at all.
Well, congratulations on the new movie, which I saw the other day. And I'll, I don't suspect that you made this movie for middle-aged men such as myself, probably for slightly younger people. But I really enjoyed it. It's a fun movie. Describe a little bit what Monte Carlo is about.
Monte Carlo, it's like a romantic comedy slash adventure. It's really cute. It's about three girls that travel to Europe to have an awesome vacation. It ends up being a complete disaster, and they bump into a British heiress that I also play, and it's kind of a case of mistaken identity, and we decide to switch lives with her and without her knowing. And intertwined with all of that, we have our own like little romance stories.
Yeah, little love stories also going on at the same time. One of the things that really struck me about this film were the beautiful, beautiful locations where you shot. Make everyone jealous and tell everybody where you were and how much fun that was.
Well, the first 6 weeks we shot in Budapest and Hungary, and that was really amazing because you don't really think about Hungary being a hot vacation spot, but it was actually really awesome. Then we shot in Paris for about 5 days.
Not too shabby.
No,
there's where you can do some shopping damage right there.
I didn't do as much as my friend Leighton did on the movie. She did a lot of shopping. It's a little expensive there, but I did eat a lot. I did eat a lot when I was there.
Yeah.
And then we shot the last 2 weeks in Monte Carlo.
Yeah. Amazingly gorgeous there as well.
Yes, the beaches were really pretty. Like, the water was so clear. I'd never seen that water that blue.
And the other thing that really struck me with this were the not only this great ensemble who is around you, but some of your producers, like Nicole Kidman, like Forrest Whitaker. That's not too shabby.
No.
How involved were they?
I did meet Nicole before the film started, and she was really nice and so sweet. And she also sent me flowers on the first day of shooting to wish me good luck. So she was very sweet, and she was very happy with the film. I saw her afterwards, and she had saw some of it. She was actually shooting Just Go With It during the time we were shooting.
Yeah. Was this more challenging for you? I mean, certainly you are no... you're not being introduced to acting for the first time. You've done it most of your life, really. But I'm wondering if this was a little bit different for you because you played dual roles and really, at times, a third role of your character playing another character consciously in the film. So really, you were kind of playing three different people in this movie.
Yeah, and I think that it was good for me. It was different. Obviously, on my show I used to work on, I played one character for like 5 years. So it was a big challenge for me to be able to do two characters and then a British accent who was completely evil. But it was really fun for me, and I feel like my fans are going to be excited to see me do a different character.
Was the evil character more fun to play?
Yes.
Than I mean, the nice character just seems like you.
Thank
just really
you.
Just sort of down to earth, and but this evil character is
awesome.
Cut from the Alexis Carrington old dynasty cloth. It's just really an awful person.
Yeah, she was so great to play though, because it was so I felt really bad a couple of times though, obviously, but it was really fun for me to play that character.
Why did you feel bad? Because you had to be so mean.
I mean, especially the part where I had to slap my love interest at one point was horrible because it took me about 25 takes to do it.
Did you do that on purpose, really?
No, because it wasn't hurting him. I just did this. Like, I barely just tapped him. Yeah. And
he reacts. He reacts and makes it look like it was a
good
one.
He tries to, but then he's just like, then he just stopped and was just like, really? Can you just hit me already? I was like, okay. I just felt bad.
So you really wailed on him.
I had to the last time.
That was the take. That was the take that they took,
yes.
Right? Is this going to kind of take you in a new direction now? Are you going to be more acting away from music? I mean, how does this position you now? Starring in your own movie, that's a pretty big deal.
I hope so. I mean, I hope it's the start of something. I love doing films. I've done a series for about 5 years, so it would be really nice for me to be able to step into really fun films that are different for me.